Let's start with different types of parenchyma now. Right. So, type of parenchyma. Let's study the type of parenchyma and what it contains. What it consists of and what is the function of that parenchyma. What is the function of that parenchyma? Okay, first type of parenchyma is chlorenchyma. Chlorenchyma is the parenchymatous tissue which consists of chloroplasts in it. Hence it is called as chlorenchyma. So, it consists of chloroplasts, hence it is called as chlorenchyma. And when it consists of chloroplasts, what would be its function? Its function will be photosynthesis. It is involved in the synthesis of food, photosynthesis, that is food synthesis. Okay, next type of parenchyma. Next type of parenchyma is aerenchyma. Aerenchyma is a type of parenchyma which consists of air in the intercellular spaces. Actually, this parenchyma, aerenchyma, consists of a network of intercellular spaces. A network of intercellular spaces are present in this type of parenchyma. Network of intercellular spaces. I am writing it as ICS. And in this network of intercellular spaces, large intercellular spaces are filled with air, which are filled with air. And hence, they help in floating of hydrophytes over the surface of water. Okay. So, aerenchyma is present in hydrophytes which help in floating of these plants, hydrophytic plants, aquatic plants over the surface of water. They help in floating. That is the function of this aerenchyma. And this aerenchyma is also present in some terrestrial plants. This is about hydrophytes. It is also present in some terrestrial plants like Canna and banana. Canna and banana. Where it is present in Canna and banana? It is present in petioles. In petioles it is present. In Canna and banana plants, it is present in the petioles of leaves. And this aerenchyma which is present in Canna and banana, that is in petioles, is in the form of, is with star-shaped parenchyma. The cells of this parenchyma are star-shaped. Hence, it is also called as stellate parenchyma. Stellate parenchyma or stellate aerenchyma, like this. Stellate parenchyma or stellate aerenchyma, like this. Okay, so I am writing here stellate parenchyma or stellate aerenchyma. Okay, next type of parenchyma. Next type of parenchyma is idioblastic parenchyma. Idioblasts. Idioblasts are the parenchymatous cells which are involved in, which consists of secretory substances. Secretory substances, because they secrete, these idioblastic cells, parenchymatous cells which are idioblasts, secrete some substances like oils, nectar, gums, etc. Oils, nectar, gums, etc. So this is secretory parenchyma or idioblastic parenchyma. Next type of parenchyma is storage parenchyma. So the storage parenchyma is storage parenchyma. It is involved in storage of food. Storage of food. What it contains? It contains food. Stored food. Stored food. For example, endosperm of seed. Endosperm of seed. Okay, endosperm of seed. Consists of what? It stores food. Endosperm of seed stores food. Stores food And the next thing is, this type of storage parenchyma is also present in some xerophytes. Some xerophytes which store water, mucilage, and even food also. For example, xerophytic plants like Opuntia and aloe. In aloe and Opuntia, they are involved in storage of water in the form of mucilage. Actually, these are xerophytic plants. In these xerophytic plants, what happens during rainy season, they absorb more amount of water and they store that water in the form of mucilage, and they utilize that water which is stored in the form of mucilage during summer season. So, aloe and Opuntia. So, this is about different types of parenchymatous tissue. Now, let's study different types of colenchymatous tissue. Types of colenchyma.